Well, hello, my friends. Welcome to the Artist Next Level podcast. Super happy, super excited to be here with you today because we have here with us a special guest, none other than Nadine Robins. Nadine is a great friend of mine. We have known each other for, I don't know how many years, through the art community, through different projects that we have done together, through all kinds of exhibitions as well. And so it's been really good to have Nadine here with us today. Nadine is a fantastic artist. She is a realist painter, and you know, we have a lot to chat about today. You know, her relationship with social media. You know, she grew up a really exciting community on TikTok as well, and she has also a special really project that she just released too. I'm really excited to share with you guys, and we're gonna learn a little bit more about what Nadine is doing right now, you know, what she's up to. So stay tuned, because it's gonna be a great chat.
Resources, inspiring interviews, business practices, and practical advice to take your art career to the next level. Join Sergio Gomez in today's Artist Next Level and get ready to take control of your career.
So Nadine, good to see you. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. All's good. How are you doing? Sounds like you're doing well. And before we do anything, I just want to make a point of thanking you for everything that you do. And I speak for a lot of people. So, you know, I want to make sure that, myself included, you really helped me early on.
Yeah.
When you started, you know, the Art Next Level program.
Yeah.
And I was a part of it, and it really was, you know, good fundamentals that have helped me in my career. So
thank you, Nadine. Thank you for mentioning that. Yes. And actually, we met in New York. You know, we went for a show, and then we did a talk there, and then you came, and then that's where we actually, I think, met for the first time.
In Chicago. You said New York, right?
I went to New York. Yeah.
Did we meet in New York?
Yeah. We met in New York. It was, I don't remember what year it was.
I know.
It was before you came to Chicago for the exhibits. I wish I could remember the year. It was with my friend Luis Martin. He had a show there. He invited us to put a show there. And we did a little talk, and you came, met, and we chatted. So
it was
fun. But I'm sure, you know, other ways.
Oh, there's so many things, you know, we do. So
super. So Nadine, for the friends who do not know you right now, can you please tell us a little bit about yourself? You know, where are you located? What kind of art you make? What inspired you as an artist?
Okay, well. I am a former graphic designer, creative director. I had a little studio of my own for many years, and just couldn't take the pressure anymore. And I had always wanted to be an artist, not a graphic designer. And so an opportunity came up to just close my business, and I never looked back. I've been painting ever since, and it started very loosely. My early work was much more impressionistic, but I always was drawn to realism, and then photorealism, and then hyperrealism. And so my work's gone from, you know, so many different stages. And so I would call myself, you know, a hyperrealist painter, but I have a very unique approach to it, because my intention is not to copy the photo. It inspires me, that love of detail. But when I start looking closer to my paintings, or people do, they'll realize, oh my God, no, it's not at all a photo. So that's kind of fun that, what else?
Tell us also a little bit of your subjects, you know, as an artist, you know, what impressions you put on the canvas. Tell us a little bit about how you pick the people you work with as for your subjects.
Oh, well, there's lots of different ways that I approach people. I have been known to approach people on the streets. If I have something about them, you know, some people, it's not necessarily about beauty. You know, when I pick people, It's just certain people have a charisma. They have something that
something.
And I feel very lucky with some photography background as well as a designer that I have this innate ability to sort of see somebody and know, oh my God, that could be a really beautiful portrait. So I meet people that way. I meet people, you know, social media all over the place. And specifically, I'm starting to work on a fairly large project that I went to this party. And I won't get into it because it's part of a solo show that I'm doing. So there's a really great story. And it does tie into something else we're going to talk about. But I went to this party and there was maybe about 30 women. Average like 30 years old. And what a community. It was so inspiring. They were so nice to each other. They were so welcoming. You know, I'm 57, hanging out with all these 30 years old. And the energy was so fantastic. And they knew that I did photography and they liked my paintings. And they said, you know, come to the party, take some pictures.
Oh, okay.
So I did. I took all these wonderful pictures of all these young ladies that with great energy. And out of all of them, most photo shoots, there's always just that one photo, you know, I see it and I instantly know that that's the one, that's the one. And so I think it was maybe the last 10 minutes at the party, it was getting dark out and they're all having a good time. I'm not drinking or anything. And I'm like, okay, it's time for me to go. But I took this one picture of a friend of mine and her name is Ayla. And it was just unbelievable. I saw that photo and I was like, okay, that's it. I'm good. This is, you know, this was the start of something. And yeah, so I'm excited. And so I guess, yeah, that's otherwise, you know, I've hired models and good ones.
And sometimes your family members, right, have been in some of the really good portraits.
Forget my family. Yes, my family. You know, people tell me my paintings can sometimes be too personal. And I'm like, well, yeah, of course. They are personal. And any painting that I've done, and I think most artists would, you know, agree. And so, yes, I painted my son and I've painted my husband years ago, not recently, and my brother with, you know, the glasses.
That, and by the way, that was a hit, you know, that portrait. And he's round, really cool glasses.
Wait.
We have to see. Okay.
These glasses have kind of toured the country trying to get people to wear them and photograph them.
Oh, look at that.
Nice, right?
Now, did you pick the glasses for him or where did the glasses story came?
The glasses were purchased many years ago. For the first series of paintings I did that were very loose. And a friend of mine really had the type of hair and a look of Janis Joplin. And I love music and it always kind of shows itself in my work, especially like the square format, the LPs. And so I bought this for her and I've never painted the photograph with the glasses because I was afraid of the hair. I mean, she just... I just couldn't do it. I wasn't ready for it. But my brother and I have this thing where he'll take my camera sometimes and take this crazy picture of himself. And I don't know until I start looking at the picture. And so he did it again. And I said, well, wait a second. You know, he saw these glasses in my studio and he took them. I didn't like the shot he did. And I said, well, let's do another one. And so this is version 3.0 because I've painted him three times over the years. He's always got the glasses on. He's always making some fun face. And, and so, and I just was like, this is perfect. It's so him. It's so him. He's fun. And people did love it. I mean, viral videos. I got a really nice commission on TikTok because of it. And it's still... you know, it has a life of its own.
Yeah, and it's one of those portraits, you know, with all the plethora of art that is done every day and shared every day, but, you know, sometimes you see something that just sticks in your head. That's one of them, of your work, that for me is just kind of like, is right here. I can see it, you know?
Oh, that's nice to hear. Yeah.
It was really fun. And, you know, you have a wonderful community also that you have grown on TikTok, over 100,000 followers there. And, you know, the response that you got from that, the whole process of painting it, and then introducing your brother, the actual person, you know, it was really, really fun to see. And
yeah. Oh, the comments, I have to say too, though, they were so funny. I mean, they saw him in his overalls and so many people were like, oh my God, you know, I want him as my brother. Or
that's so cool.
What's the brand name on those overalls? I sent it to my brother and I was like, oh, you have to look at the comments.
You're the star now. Yeah.
And he was just very, you know, this side of him is very shy. So it was cute.
And that's one of the beautiful things about, you know, painting, and about picking a subject that is so somebody that you know, because brings also a different pressure, you know, to actually put that portrait into the surface and then to the eyes of the public, you know, and the likeness of that person, you know, it's something that is something special for the artist.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Oh yeah, if you know the person, it really comes out in a painting. Yeah. So I like to do that, to get to know people a little bit before I paint them. Right. So that helps.
Another of the portraits that you have done that really has also stuck in my head is the one from the collector Howard Tolman.
Oh yes, really, oh my God. I have all the props here too. Wait, really? Let's enjoy this. Wait, let's see. Here you go. I saved it from the Chicago opening.
Oh, wow. So a little bit about that story, you know, how the portrait came about. So there's for our friends who do not know, a well-known art collector here in Chicago, very supportive of the arts and artists, Howard Tolman, an entrepreneur of started many companies. And when every time he started a company, he filled it up with art from, you know, artists that he collected. And, you know, we had a chance to, through one of the exhibitions here in Chicago, many of the artists came to also tour one of his collections for a couple of times with Didi Menendez. She organized nice things with that. So tell us, I never heard of what's the story, how the portrait came about.
It's a fun story. So I have an ongoing series. I haven't touched it in a little while, but which is called Bad Habits and Guilty Pleasures.
Okay, that's perfect.
Right? We all have them, right? And so I would just ask people, you know, and it all started with this one painting I did of a poet with the orange background and the crown. Mm-hmm. And so I took it upon myself to just contact, you know, well, first, Howard had already collected a painting of mine, a nude. So we knew each other. And I was coming to Chicago and I just decided, okay, you know, I managed to reach out to Howard and I said, hey, Howard, you know, I'm doing this new series called Bad Habit and Guilty Pleasures. Are you interested in participating? And he just instantly was like, yes. I was like,
with that title, I think.
Yes, I was like, okay. And I said, well, what's your bad habit then, or guilty pleasure? And he says, I drink Diet Coke double gulps all day long.
Oh my goodness.
And no wonder he's, you know, running businesses and doing just, you know, he's the Energizer Bunny.
You're right.
And so he said yes. And I was, it was fantastic. So I think it was a few months later, I was in Chicago and I was working with her assistant. And she says, you got 15 minutes.
Okay.
That was it. And so we were at his, 871?
Yes.
That big building.
Right.
And so I went up there and he had the drink and I got 15 minutes with him. And I was like, oh my God, please. Please let me catch it. And I did. I there was that one shot. I was like, he's just looking at the camera, kind of like, I'm in on the joke, you know.
Yeah, no, and I love it. It's another of those memorable pieces that for me, you know, has stuck in my head out.
And
he loved that painting because he had it as his profile also for a long time.
Yeah, he does. Yeah. He has it on his blog and it was fun because it was, when I ask people to paint, my intention is not with the expectation that they're going to buy it. Never. Yeah. But it just happened to be his 70th birthday. So his wife was like, oh, I have to have that. And it was kind of fun because they took the photo, the painting, and they put it all over the place.
Yeah, yeah.
The celebration of the party. So it was a good time. And I like it when people appreciate a piece of art, and it became a celebration. So it was fun.
Yeah, no, and that's a wonderful thing, you know, that happens, you know, as part of the process and the stories, you know, that evolve after even the work is done. You know, how I'm always fascinated by how art moves in the world, you know, and that's why I became a curator and do the gallery tours, because I really find it fascinating to hear how the thing that we make in the studio enters the world and then it has a life of its own. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it might take many years, you know, for something to actually find its life. And for everyone listening here, you know, don't get desperate when sometimes you have painting sitting in the studio for 10 years to eventually one day somebody looks at it like, that's the one I've been looking for, you know?
Yeah, you have to have a lot of patience as an artist, don't you?
Exactly. And speaking of patience, I think that's a great segue into what I'm going to talk about next, because in order to paint a hyper-realistic technique, and particularly the way you do it, you need a lot of patience, right? You have to really work on each section of that portrait for a long, long time. And you recently released a video, which is a project I would love to chat with you about, in which you did a video, 4 hours of you painting just the eye of the subject, right? I don't have that patience for the little section.
Right.
But tell me about that.
Yes, well, I'll just put it out there. The video is 4 hours, but the amount of time that it took me to do it with a lot of editing, it was more like almost 16 hours, I think.
16 hours to do the eye?
To do all the stages of the eye. Yeah, it took a long time. And
wow, okay. Now that is
slow
even
painter.
More.
I know. I don't know. It depends. You know, it's funny. People think that I have a lot of patience. I actually don't.
Okay.
But the beauty of these paintings, the hyperreal technique, is that it calms me down. Mm. I get into this sort of flow, as they say, and I lose time.
Okay.
And so the detail of it, I don't get stuck in it. I just get lost. And it's actually meditative a bit, you know? So, but yeah, so how did this come about? Let's go back to talk about the party briefly.
Right. Yeah.
So I'm invited to this party, and Ayla was one of the few people that I actually had met prior to the party. She'd actually helped me do a promo video for myself. That's how we met on Facebook.
Oh, okay.
And she lived locally. We met, we did the video. So once I saw this picture, and I'll, you know what, for those of you that are watching this, you're going to get to see it first, but there it is. That is the painting that it all started. That's the photo I took at the last part of the party.
Okay.
And one of the things that I've wanted to do to try to improve my skills is to do more studies.
Okay.
And so I have doing more studies of like eyes or nose or hands or lips or anything like that. And so I decided to start recording these studies. Mm-hmm. And I've always been really good at recording, you know, even before like Facebook and whatnot, I have videos of always recording my process. I find it fascinating. Collectors online now, they like it. I love to share it. I tend to be very generous that way. And so I shot the whole video, and I decided to make a demo to put out there. And, you know, one of the reasons, I have to say, one of the main reasons that I did it is to educate people too, though, with this wonderful craft that I have that I want to pass on to others. And TikTok taught me that, because the young demographic there, they want this, and nobody is encouraging them to do hyperrealism. They're actually being discouraged. Hmm. And that's heartbreaking to me. So that kind of, you know, was one of the inspirations to do this. And, but it's evolving into, the first video is, people have probably seen it, called Painting Ayla My Way. Mm-hmm. And I was specific to that because I'm painting Ayla, and I'm going to be actually, of course, recording the whole process of doing the painting of Ayla. It's rather a large one. And The first is painting Ayla's eye. Well, the next one's going to be painting Ayla's lips. And so for every portrait that I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be recording it like this and wanting to share the studies that I do all the way until you get to the painting. And I'm just such a better painter doing the studies before.
Yeah.
And I highly recommend that any artist, if you have the opportunity to be able to record your process and share it and occasionally want to try to sell something, it's important because we need it. We need different sources of income. But I have a big project coming up.
But before we go to the project, so let's go back to this. I want to really dive in deeper into the video.
Yes. Okay.
Make it let our friends how they can get it too as well. And one of the things that I love about this video that you created, because I had a chance to see it, and so even though it's 4 hours, you have broken it down into 4 sections, so you don't have to get lost in where was I when I left, right? So it makes it easier for somebody to watch. I love that, you see the whole process. You talk through what you are doing, but you're not talking straight for 4 hours. Mm-hmm. You have these periods where, you say some things which are important to your process, your methods, and then there's I find it very soothing. It's a nice then background music as we see you painting, and every single part, every single brushstroke, every single dab of paint, how it goes to create that eye. And that was fascinating to see that my process is very different, right? I'm all over the place in the canvas, right? You're so carefully, as I was looking at the video from video 1, 2, 3, and 4, from the beginning to the very end when the painting is finished, and then you go back in the video and say done. So I think it's a really wonderful opportunity. It's also a really wonderful educational tool for any artist who wants to get better at their skill, particularly if they're working in the realism spectrum, hyperrealism, or just getting better at doing eyes. When I was watching the video, my daughter was having breakfast, and she just finished high school. Well, she's finishing high school, and she's taking art classes, so she's been doing paintings, and right now she's finishing a painting of hers when she was little, and she was painting the eyes the other day. So she saw me painting, looking at your video, like, look, Naya, she said look, and she came and she saw it from a distance. She's like, oh my god, that is amazing. And I said, you will never believe all the steps that Nadine goes through in order to make that just one eye. And she was fascinated by it. But anyone who wants to get better at, I believe that as artists, we should always be students as well. And we should always get better. I'm always looking also for ways in which I can improve my skill. How can I get better at what I do? So I think this is a great resource for somebody, particularly on a place where everyone is trying to make courses that are quick, just a 10-minute quick, watch it, and they fast forward the entire process, and it's like a cartoon, like, and then it's over, right? Like, okay, but and I found it to be quite a great concept for you to do the opposite and say, no, I'm not going to fast forward the process. I'm going to show it in the video in real time, as I'm making it. And I think that's the beauty of it. And I think that's what makes your course, this video, so unique and straightforward, in that, somebody could be really studying, your step by step as you're making it, as they listen to what you're doing as well. I think that's great. So I think for many artists who may be listening right now, if you want to get better at this, pretty much I would say I highly recommend it. And some of the good perks also of checking out Hit the Artist Next Level podcast is that right now there's an early bird pricing if you want to get that course. And so tell us a little bit about how, what is it and where our friends can go to find the course, and also what's the deadline for this early bird special that you have going?
Okay. The deadline is Memorial Day at midnight on May 29th. And I'm pricing it out now at $50 instead of $300. because I really want people to check it out. And, you know, the video is really the only part of the video that I didn't record because I forgot to. I'll be better on the second one, but still, I really wanted to show the whole process, and I was very careful to show all the supplies that I use and why I use them, and not forcing people into using my tools. Whatever anybody's tools are, they're their tools. And I wanted people to feel sort of, it was more personal, I guess, the way that I wanted to deliver the video. And so after that, yes, you're right. I come in, I pop in. I even have my famous red sweatshirt that I wear in my studio all the time.
Your red outfit.
And I also talk about the block-in stage, which in realism, people will, you know, do a grisaille, you know, with and all in sort of values and in one color. And that's great. For me, I felt that with hyperrealism, in order to get that glow that you can get in a portrait, that I would do that underpainting, the block-in it's called, in color. And to understand color, to understand, you know, values and things like that. And then I would build on top of that is where all the details go in. So people will be able to see the whole block-in part of it. And with more explanation. And also, I got a second camera and I put it on the side so they can actually see me, you know, picking the paints and then going to the painting. And then the longer part of the video is the detail section. And I took out the palette on that because that part was not about paint mixing or whatnot. This is about just watching me with all my little paint strokes. And then there's a little picture, you know, of the reference photo that also shows on all the video. Some nice music, like you said. And it was fun to do. And I did like doing the longer form. You know, there's actually a 10-minute clip of it on my YouTube channel.
Awesome. So you can get a taste. And highly recommended. Remember the deadline, May 29, if you want to get like this super amazing discount. It's a one-time payment. And then you have access to the whole thing. So
unlimited. Yes. And I have it on, just want people to know that it's hosted on Podia.
Okay.
Which is a very interesting platform.
And what's your website where they can actually go and
Buy the course? Yeah, they can go to nadinerobinsart.com. And when they get to the nav, there's a button right there, how to paint an eye.
Perfect.
It goes through all the information. It's pretty short read.
Super. And if you find Nadine on Instagram or you follow her on Instagram, Nadine Robins Artist on Instagram, just go to her profile link right there. And I'm going to put it also in the description of this video. I'll put a direct link to it so you guys can check it out. All right. So now you said you have some like big exciting project coming up. So what is that one?
Oh yes. Well, you know, I've been on a lot of Zooms and sort of absorbing a lot of information the past few years. And you know, I really want to have a solid solo show somewhere. I'm not sure yet. It depends on how the project. But what I've learned is that, you know, if you want to make a really big statement, and I do, is that you have to work big. But the problem with working big is that it costs money. People don't buy large paintings as much as smaller ones. And you need the capital to do that. And so part of, you know, having done the video is to help me paint what will probably be eight. One of the sketches is right here. So what's that? Six by eight.
Okay.
I had to hide it. Nobody's allowed to see any of it. you know, of course, it's figurative, portraits, nudes. It's going to mix up a lot of things. And I'm not sure exactly. I'm collecting the photos to work from first. And I have a goal, hopefully within, I know 2 years sounds like a long time, but not to paint eight large paintings. And the working title is called American Woman.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Based on the song, his music, of course, is really important to me. And I was listening to the song while I was painting. I heard American Woman, and I'm like, wait, that would be a great title for this show. And so it's a big project, lots of time, and I'm excited about it.
That's great. You know, it's really fun when as an artist, you know, we are excited for what's coming next, you know, because there are seasons sometimes where you don't know what's coming next, and that could be sometimes also difficult, and you know, sometimes may take time to get there. But like when you already have a vision, you got an idea, and then you kind of just wait to
get
on it and work on it. It's really a good place to be.
It was very exciting. You know, I took 6 months off last year. Burnout, just, you know, nothing fun was coming out of my work. I felt like it was just this machine. Mm-hmm. And that's bad art, if you ask me. You know, you can see it. And so after taking that time off, like all of a sudden, you know, I just creativity, inspiration. It just, I highly recommend, if you can, to take some time off, more than just a week or two.
So maybe let's dive in a little bit on that, because I think a lot of our friends who are listening or watching here, you know, this is a really good topic too, where sometimes we go through these dry spells. Maybe we work really hard for a season, and then we're like, you know, just scrolling to get to the end of it, or we're preparing for a show.
Yeah, you got nothing left, you know?
Yeah, so tell us a little bit about, you know, for a friend who's listening, who may be there where you were, you know, months ago, you know, what would be a good piece of advice to get back on track? What kind of help you to get out of that?
Well, I mean, you know, I can only use the experience that I recently went through. You know, it was fun. How it all began was funny. I was at a friend's house at their pool on a really hot day, and I just was having one of those days where I was manically talking about things and you know, burnt out and not knowing what my next move is going to be. And so my neighbor says, you know, Nadine, have you ever meditated?
Okay.
And I was like, okay, well, he's trying to tell me something. And so I actually started to meditate. Hmm. And what I found is that I got, you know, just like 10 minutes listening to somebody talking to me. It's very hard to meditate. but I started to do that. And within a few weeks, I realized that by sort of turning off my brain for a little bit, even just 10 minutes, I realized how burnt out and everything I was. And then my husband was like, Nadine, you know, you need some time off. And so I just said, okay, what do I have in my savings? And I took the time off. And I did nothing. I mean, I wasn't really online, although people thought I was. Everything was really automated. Mm-hmm. I stepped away from it all. I went to, you know, visit friends and family. I mean, I really nourished myself with everything not related to art. And I only had one project that I had to do. Otherwise, I just, you know, I was in the garden, and I just did all these things that I had been putting aside, because I was so frantic that I wasn't painting enough. Mm-hmm. But yet the one thing I had to do was to stop painting, go back, you know, figure out some things, and then come back to it with a fresh perspective. And that's exactly what happened. When I came back to it, actually, I have to say, I was really frustrated, because I still wasn't happy, still wasn't inspired. I'm like, oh my God, this is it. I'm going to have to get a full-time job. But there was a delay. Like, I never saw that. There was like a 2 to 3 week delay. And then all of a sudden it was like, oh my God, like the, you know, the heavens. That was it. All of a sudden I was like, there's that energy again. And this year I've already painted 6 paintings.
Wow.
Which I haven't done, in a long time. 6 paintings in 5 months. I mean, I've been, so that just goes to show you that it goes against what you think you should do, taking time off, but it's exactly what you need to do to be more productive and more creative and sort of really enjoy the whole process. Because I wasn't enjoying myself. I was, you know, that's no fun.
That is golden advice, Nadine. You know, that's really, really good advice. A good reminder for all of us. You know, I think as artists, sometimes we, or many times, we overwhelm ourselves, you know, and we don't realize that we are putting all these pressures on, like you said, you know, oh, I have to post, you know, I have to do this, I have to do that, I have to. And when we are running on our career, we are the CEO, we are the chief, you know, we can give ourselves a vacation and it's okay. And giving ourselves that permission, as you did, takes courage, you know, and planning. And but then the reward on the other side, as we can see, you all the things you're doing now, you're doing this course, you're doing this, and so many good things are happening.
Well, it's energy.
Exactly.
The two steps back just gave you 10 forward. It doesn't make sense in how we've all been educated. You know, you're just supposed to work all the time.
Mm-hmm. And it's kind of like this American mentality of, you know, you gotta like fight for the dream. And, you know, if you lose one day, somebody else will take your spot, you know?
Yes, exactly. I'm a type A Capricorn. So, you know, my ambition is just, you know, it's incredible and it's a wonderful thing. But at the same time, you know, somebody who can be that ambitious, you end up burning out. And I've recognized it, which is really important, and accept that it's just part of being human, you know. And, you know, if you want to be a good artist, it's great to step back for yourself, for what you want to do. And, you know, I don't know. You just feel so much more alive. So it's 2023. Woohoo!
Exactly. No, I love
it. Yeah.
I love that.
People will enjoy the. Here, wait. I got more stuff they can see.
Look at that. That's amazing. That is beautiful. That is beautiful.
Oh, yeah. So they'll get to see everything from, was it in the supply video? You get to see just the outline where I started and then everything until I finished it. So
super.
I think that it will be really helpful for people. I hope.
Yeah. Well, Nadine, you've been so awesome. You know, thank you for your words of encouragement here, you know, to all the artists. I'm sure they're going to land in special hearts today, you know, that somebody out here listening or watching needs that time off. And then I know many of you guys too need to take that course, you know, so make sure you check that out. The painting the eye, what's the title of the course again?
Oh, it's called Painting Ayla's Eye My Way.
Exactly.
How to paint a hyperrealistic eye in oil paint. And,
perfect.
$529 is the deadline, and then the price goes up. But
get it by May 29. Yeah, get it, my friends. Highly recommend it. Like I said, I watched it. Super cool. And I'm not a hyper-realistic painter, but I enjoy it as an artist, you know, to see how you did it. So thank you, my friends. Thank you, Nadine, for joining us today.
I want to wish you. It's always great to talk to you. I really, your pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah, and I want to wish you a great success in everything that you're doing. Looking forward to see further videos that you are doing in your series. Looking forward to also see this new big project that you have
I'll show some of it. I can't help myself. I have to show
exactly. So make sure you follow Nadine on Instagram and also on TikTok.
Put it right there.
Nadine Robins Artist. Make sure you follow that. You'll find the link also on the description of this video. And thank you for joining us. Thank you, Nadine. And please, my friends, do us a big favor if you're watching this or listening to this in the podcast. If you're on the podcast, of course, give us a good review and share it with your friends. And if you're watching this on any social media or in YouTube, either subscribe or also, which takes 1 second to do, just click that little button that says share. So share it with your friends, share in your socials, tag Nadine, tag myself, and we would really, really appreciate it. So have a great rest of your day, and we'll see you at the next level.
Check out our website at www.theartistnextlevel.com, where you will find our podcast library, learn about our upcoming webinars, find resources relevant to your career, and much more. Thanks for listening to today's podcast, and we'll see you at the next level.